Moisés, muy buenos días. Saludos a Carrie Filippetti y a todos los panelistas en este importante encuentro. Gracias. Thank you very much for this opportunity. Today, the greatest real threat against Colombian democracy are the criminal structures with tentacles abroad, especially in our neighborhood, dedicated to the business of illicit drugs and the illegal extraction of minerals. These criminal structures do not care about profiting from these illegal activities that destroy the environment or about whatever illegal business they can control. Criminals see no borders in their overflowing desire for dirty money. Both crimes, illicit drugs and the illicit extraction of minerals, are powerful factors of destruction. They generate poverty, destroy lives, and destroy our environment. Only the heads of those organizations reap benefits, and it is a temporary and ephemeral benefit which in no way justifies the cost it entails. I have been saying this in various forums, at the risk that political sectors, enemies of the government of President Duque, will come out to say that this is a conspiracy against them, or against our neighbors whom they defend. Illegal mining has been a strategic source of financing for illegal groups in Colombia for many years. Of course, this is not new, and we have been fighting them. The damage they have done is immense. The indiscriminate use of substances, such as cyanide or mercury, factually contaminates the water sources of our farmers. But they also enslave very vulnerable people and put them to work in their ranks, and then they kill them. They affect local economy and institutions. And now, we are facing the fact that many of the illegal structures that commit crimes in Colombia have found haven in the dictatorship of Nicolás Maduro in Venezuela to strengthen their criminal enterprises affecting us all greatly. As it is well known, in the face of the economic crisis and especially due to the losses of oil revenues, the Maduro government has used gold to finance international operations. According to intelligence information, 80% of the gold mined in Venezuela comes from the illegal exploitation of minerals. For years, the protection the Maduro regime has given the ELN has been known. Well, they then listen to this. In Catatumbo, norte de Santander, the ELN would be entering gold illegally mined in the states of Bolívar, Apure, and Amazonas in Venezuela. And it relies on those resources to finance its violent actions in Colombia. In Guainía, the ELN and the Gao Residual Acacio Medina structure would be entering Venezuela in order to extract gold and black soil to strengthen their criminal economies. An important illegal mining activity in the Yapacana mines stands out. In Puerto Carreño, Vichada, an organization called Los Chatarreros has presence dedicated to the trafficking of minerals such as gold, diamonds, and black soil illegally stolen from the Orinoco mining arc in Venezuela to transport it to Colombia, Panama, Puerto Rico, and Spain. GAO residual members have regrouped in the Venezuelan state of Amazonas and have resorted to the illicit exploitation of minerals to finance their expansion. The minerals illegally mined in Venezuela are transported by river on the Orinoco River to Puerto Carreño and later to the city of Bogotá. This reality forced us to reinforce controls at the border to fight these criminal organizations which generate violence in our country and prevent them not only from continuing to destroy our resources and murdering our peasants and social leaders, but we also need to impact their sources of financing. The issue here is that this matter becomes more complex if these criminal networks have the support, as it is known, of neighboring authorities and states. These facts generate new realities for us that Colombia must know and measure as a real threat against our democracy. As I mentioned, organizations engaging in illicit extraction of minerals not only destroy our country and kill our peasants and social leaders, but have spread its tentacles beyond our borders. In the different stages of this chain, drug trafficking organizations become part of it and, in many cases, manage to penetrate the financial systems. Illicit mining has also generated negative social impacts in the areas where it is undertaking, fostering threats to the security of citizens, displacement of foreigners to those regions, hence the presence of numerous Venezuelans, Brazilians, and Ecuadorians, and misshaping and generating illegal dynamics that affect the institutionality and local economy. From a transnational perspective, illicit extraction of minerals makes it hard to track their transactions. The weakness of national and international laws does not help to identify the origin of minerals and makes easy the use of these resources as a currency on drug trafficking and money laundering transactions. The illicit economy based on the illicit extraction of minerals and its subsequent money laundering has a complex route and network of actors such as illegal organizations, national and international authorities and companies. These criminal organizations make transactions with foreign clients, which on itself constitute a money laundering enterprise, since it derives from an illicit activity such as illegal mining. On this fraudulent operation, the drug trafficker sends cocaine to his criminal partner abroad, either in the United States, Mexico, United Kingdom, Spain, or others. Then, the illegal partner abroad makes a fraudulent gold import from Colombia or other countries, such as Panama or Venezuela, to a paper company or a real company but associated with the drug trafficker. It is imperative that, at the international level, we succeed in agreeing on the need to broaden the spectrum of the fight against these criminal organizations. In this order of ideas, we need international cooperation to be successful against this phenomenon. Just to give an example, Switzerland reports that less gold has entered its country than Colombia reports has exported, and the United States reported that more gold entered Switzerland than what Colombia actually exported. This reveals the need to cooperate even further. It is necessary that the demand for gold at international level finds a way to certify to the buyer where the gold is coming from and that there is a system of responsibility in place for the demand similar to the Kimberley process with the so-called blood diamonds. Although between governments we are already working on some of these issues, from here I commend the international community to establish better instruments of cooperation against these criminal structures. That is why, for some time, Colombians have listened to me talking insistently about the necessary international cooperation on different fronts, something on which we are not going to let our guard down. Yes, we require more international cooperation, because deep down, the dirty money of these criminals, with the help of their tentacles abroad, strengthens their actions against our democracy. Thank you very much.